What's up, guys? Okay, so 3 months ago, after the lockdown started, I decided to start uploading weekly videos because I was bored. So we started off at about 1,000 subscribers, and today, we just reached 10,000 subscribers. So last week, I reached out on Instagram to ask you guys for content ideas, and I received a ton of incredible questions from you guys. So let's just jump straight to the Q&A. Okay, let's start with this one. What gear do I use to film my videos? ...90% of the shots you see on this channel is shot by my Sony a7 III with a 24-105 f4 lens. But of course, sometimes you want to capture a spontaneous moment, or let's say you're trying to film something without carrying a huge-ass camera around. That's when I use my Sony RX100 Mark VI. It's light, it's portable, and it's really good. Aside from cameras, there are also other ways to spice up your videos, and my favorite addition to the kit is the DJI Mavic Air. Gloria, Gloria. Of course, I have my GoPro to help me capture all my action footage, water activities, and time lapses. Yup, so that's about it for my gear setup. On to the Q&A. Okay, since we are on the topic of gear, there were a few questions about my study abroad experiences, so let's get that out of the way first. Which is my favourite travel destination based on my experience? Initially, it was Iceland, but then again, we didn't manage to see the Northern Lights even though we were there for 9 days. So I think the trip to the Arctic Circle is my favourite because we ended up seeing the Northern Lights on our last day that we were there. Like, because we caught the Northern Lights tonight, right? I think this might be like the best trip in my life. And being able to catch the Northern Lights with my girlfriend was the most magical experience of my life. Okay, so either ways, I have a full documentary of both trips on my channel, so do check that out if you haven't seen it already. Where would I want to visit after this whole pandemic is over? Okay, I really want to visit the Isle of Skye in Scotland and also Meteora in Greece. I definitely also want to do snowboarding, so maybe go to Hokkaido. Hopefully this whole virus ends in about a year, so we'll be able to go for our graduation trip. Alright, let's talk about school. Okay, so my prof just sent me some Zoom background. So let's just switch things up a little here. And there we go. Okay, and let's get this stupid green screen cap off. Alright. So Victoria asks, how does the bell curve work in NUS? Does this make students competitive? So a bell curve is essentially a normal distribution because of the symmetrical bell curve shape. So there's a 25th percentile, there's a mean, and there's a 75th percentile. As you can see over here, I generally aim to be above the 75th percentile in order to score at least an A- for my modules. And in terms of competitiveness, it definitely is really competitive here, especially in business school. But I feel like having a bit of healthy competition is actually good because it encourages you to be more creative with your class participation and also encourages you to take self-learning out of the classroom as well. Okay, next question. Everybody has a wake-up period in terms of studies. When did you? Okay, so this is a really good question. In my first semester of university, I actually didn't really do too well in terms of grades because as a freshman, I played a little too much. I joined way too many CCAs in hall. I partied almost every single week and I was also very busy chasing my girlfriend back then. Okay, so I guess for me, my wake-up period was when I got back my semester 1 results and I saw that my GPA was much lower than most of my friends. And that was when I decided, like, okay, it's time to get serious. Okay, so we've come a long way since then and I'll talk about this more in a future video. What is my number one advice for people going into university? My number one piece of advice is to smash the subscribe button, hit the notifications bell because school is starting next week and I have a whole ton of fresh new content coming up as well as university advice, so you guys don't want to miss out on that. Alright, let's move on to productivity. Oh, Chibi. Chibi? I'm doing a Q&A here. Chibi, look at me. Chibi, I'm gonna continue doing the Q&A, so can you please go to your condo? Okay, good boy. Let's go. Go! Good boy! Well, how about no ask? What time management tool do I use? Okay, so I plan my entire schedule using the Notes app on my iPhone. And I also use my planner as well. So my planner is for macro planning. Usually I plan out a few weeks in advance, or maybe plan out like the monthly goals that I set out to achieve that month. And my notes is for my micro day-to-day schedules or to-do list. Sadan Raja asks, how to become a productivity master in college? So I receive a ton of questions about productivity and time management. So I don't want to go too deeply into that because I actually have a full video on this in the next 1 or 2 weeks. So stay tuned for that. So the topic I actually want to cover the most today is where I find my motivation. What keeps you going in making videos while studying? Usually when I'm studying, I have all these crazy ideas that come to my head, and I'm always so distracted while I'm studying because all I'm thinking about is creating content. So whenever I'm free, I will just take a camera and film all of these crazy ideas down, and they become the videos that you guys see on this channel. Estelle asks, tips on staying motivated, discipline, and removing distractions. I don't have any specific tips on how to do this, but maybe what I can share is a mindset shift that has allowed me to stop wasting my time. And I learned this from one of my biggest inspirations, Casey Neistat.
Seneca said, it's not that we have a short time to live, but that we waste a lot of it. Right now it's go time for me. I wanna maximize every waking second. I'm never gonna get any younger, but right now I'm completely healthy, I'm full of energy, and who knows how long this will last. I doubt it's gonna be like that when I'm 50 or 60 years old, so I wanna do it now. I think life is substantiated by whatever impact or whatever contribution you can make while you're alive. The finish line's the same for everyone. We're all ending up in the same place, but while we're here, what contribution can you make? Work and building things and making things and doing things and spending time with your family, those are the ways that I feel I'm contributing, that I'm accomplishing something. So why wouldn't I want to maximize my time as efficiently as possible, to be as effective as I can with that? And that is why I say free time is the enemy of progress, because free time sitting around is not doing. And that's why I try to omit that entirely from my life.
100%. Okay, so the next one is a good question. Three things that inspire and motivate you to work. Okay, so the first is freedom. So I realized this quite a while back after doing internships and stuff that I really wanted to work for myself. I didn't want to be constrained to a 9-to-5 because there's just so many other things that I want to accomplish with my short time here on earth. So I guess freedom is the main factor that drives me. I have taken a big risk to take the path less traveled. So I really need to put in the hard work in order to make my dreams happen, and hopefully I'll be able to become my own boss for the rest of my life. The second reason is actually for my parents. So I feel like my parents have sacrificed a lot to be able to get a piece of shit like me to where I am today. I feel like the only way that I can repay them is to put in the hard work, finish my degree, and hopefully become successful in life. And maybe one day I'll be able to provide for them and hopefully buy my dad his dream car. Okay, so the third and final reason is actually my friends. So you are the average of the 5 people you spend most of your time with. And I choose to surround myself with people that inspire me and motivate me on a day-to-day basis. Take Parallax for example. I run a video production company with my friends, and the only reason why we are able to get to where we are today is because we have the same vision and the same goals. We move together as a team, as a crew, and there's just something so powerful about that. Okay, so there are also a ton of questions about Born Children, Parallax, and why I started this YouTube channel. Okay, so for now, you guys can check out this video on my channel called Story of My Life for a brief explanation, and perhaps in the future, I'll get the boys down on the channel and we'll share more about our journey.
In an upcoming video. Better just promise 4 upcoming videos of different titles in one video.
Better just give out the entire year worth of
life. I also got a lot of questions whether we are hiring interns now. And not in the meantime because the economy is pretty bad right now. But hopefully in the future if we ever expand. Okay, so I received too many questions about fitness and working out. So let's talk about it for a second. I've mentioned this a couple of times on my channel, but I'm not a fitness expert. But somehow my body transformation video actually blew up and was featured on Lad Bible. So subsequently, I followed up with another 14-day body transformation, and that video got featured on Men's Health. I guess I'm gonna continue bringing you guys along my fitness journey as well. So right now, I'm actually doing a lean bulk. I'm eating slightly above my maintenance calories at 2.4k calories, and I'll be bulking until the end of the year. So I'll definitely keep you guys updated on that. Moving on to career. So what are your plans after uni? Finance or content creation? Okay, so that's a good one. I actually talked about this dilemma in a video that I did for NUS Business School. So I graduate in about a year from now, and And if the past is any indication, a lot can happen in a year. But if all goes well, hopefully I'll still be doing this, creating content, expanding the production house with my friends, and hopefully even shifting to a bigger office. Okay, so moving on to the last and final section of this Q&A. So what are the future goals for this channel? So even my girlfriend wants to know this. So far, all of the vlogs on my channel, I have pre-produced them really well because I respect you guys' time. I really want to deliver the best, the most engaging form of content for you guys to enjoy. Okay. Anyways, when the school term starts next week, it's quite impossible to keep on producing this kind of content because it takes up a lot of time. And as you can see, last semester, I only was able to release 3 videos. I've been posting weekly and I really want to keep this up, but at the same time, I really want to live my life as well. Okay, so I've decided I'm still gonna keep up with these weekly uploads, but that also means that the production value is gonna drop by quite a lot. I'm actually gonna try something new. I'm gonna be vlogging. I actually just bought a GorillaPod and this is still an experiment. I'm still gonna try to keep the quality of these videos up and I think it's gonna be really fun. 3 times, shawty hit a nigga with the peace sign. Wasn't with me since I had the Nissan. So there's gonna be a lot more raw and real experiences. You guys are gonna see a lot more of my life, productivity, and how I balance my school, my work, my relationships. Occasionally, I will still be doing content that is heavily researched, pre-planned with high production value. But for the most part now, I'll be vlogging. Something like this where I just sit down, press record, and say whatever is on my mind. So if you guys have noticed, I also reply to each and every single one of your comments. But I apologize in advance because when the school term starts, I might not have the time to reply to your comments. But I promise I definitely read each and every one of your comments. And thank you guys for all the support on the channel so far. So this week, I'm actually starting my final year of university and I'm stoked to be able to bring you guys along for the ride. I'll see you guys next week.